wish I could create an animated trailer like Studio Ghibli 2.
With AI, you can. Let me show you how.
Welcome to our quick animation tutorial. Today we will cover how you can create a Ghibli-inspired animation trailer like the one we did in the previous video. Thanks to the power of AI, I have managed to create the whole video from scratch without having to learn how to animate or draw. And today I will be breaking down how you can do it too. Now get your pen and papers ready and let's go! Starting with the first part of any video, we have ideation. Now this is one of the most exciting parts, so go ahead and put your creativity to the test. I personally like to have my own creative input into this, so I would just use ChatGPT for inspiration and as a platform to bounce off my ideas. If you're totally clueless on where to start, you could even start by asking ChatGPT to provide you with a list of ideas or concepts to start with. However, in this situation, I decided that I would like my first project to be creating an anime trailer reimagining Harry Potter in the Studio Ghibli art style, as these are two of my favorite childhood shows. Now with a concept in mind, I'm now going to bounce off some ideas with ChatGPT. What I will do next is to type, I want to create a short trailer that is AI generated under 90 seconds, reimagining the Harry Potter story in Studio Ghibli style. And poof, as you can see, there are some pretty cool ideas here. Now, if you don't like any of these ideas, you could ask ChatGPT to provide you with a couple more until you find the one that you really like. Now, once you have an idea in mind, we can go into the next step, which is scripting. When it comes to scripting, the steps are pretty similar to the ones above, where I would continue to ask ChatGPT to provide me with a script of the idea I like, giving me a rough idea of how the flow would be for the story. Once I have that, I would edit the script accordingly, again and again until I am satisfied. Now this should be quite straightforward, and by the end of it, you should have something like this. Now that we have the ideation part done, we shall go into the next step, which is to create the scene in Midjourney. There are several other great tools like Leonardo AI, but I like the quality given by Midjourney the best, so I would be using that. Now, Midjourney is a paid tool, so you do have to pay a small fee to use it. Now what if I don't know how to prompt Midjourney? Fret not, here's what I'll do as a beginner. First up, I would ask ChatGPT once again to provide me with a list of prompts for the scenes that I have created. Now, there are three steps to this. Number one, as ChatGPT doesn't have the latest information till date, I would start by providing ChatGPT with information about Midjourney so it could help me get the prompts as close as possible. I'll do this by copying the information found in Midjourney's prompt documentation. Now, you may find them in the link in the description. Once that is done, I'll provide ChatGPT with my completed script for it to provide me with the prompts for each scene. I'll then ask ChatGPT to provide me in this format for the best results. Medium, style, scene, action, modulate, and parameters. If you are interested, I do have a free Midjourney prompt guide link in the description, so you can just refer to that. Once I get my prompt, I will start generating my images in Midjourney. Now, pro tip, to get a similar face for your characters, you can use Midjourney's vary function. Highlight the face of the characters you would like to change and add in the link for the reference image. And once you click prompt, it will provide you with a similar result. Now, this function is very effective, and if there's anything you would like to change in your images, it will help you get the best consistency possible. Wonderful! Now after this step, you should be ready to get into the fun part, which is animation. Now in this video, we are doing a basic picture warp animation, so you could just head to LayerPix, put in the image, and there you go. Of course, in the upcoming video tutorials, I will be exploring deeper on how we can create more complex animations, so stay tuned for that. Now back to LayerPix. To create stunning depth animations, just upload the picture and scene, and there you go. In the app itself, you could adjust the animation style, amount of motion, and length to your liking. And once that is done, the last thing we will need is our voiceover. Now, one of my favorite tools is to use 11labs. They have a range of voiceovers from a list of templates to a library of voices that you can use. You may also clone your voice as well if you would like. With their recent feature V2, you can now do voiceovers in different languages, which in my case, I'm able to create a Japanese voiceover for my anime trailer to really bring out the vibes. For sound effects, I use Epidemic Sound, which has a huge range of royalty-free sound effects and songs. Now with great music and sound, it will really help you elevate the film experience further. For a free version, you may also try to use something like Pixabay. And there you go, with all the resources you need, you can now piece them all together in the video editing tool of your liking. I use CapCut as it is pretty user-friendly and does the work well. With a little bit of creativity, you can now get your own animated picture trailer. Check this out.
魔法使いだよ、 ハリさん。
ポッタ、私に対して自分の注文を使う気はある。それらを発明したのは私です。私、もう目のプリンス。書いていた少年が仕事に来ますか？ハリさん、私たちの能力をはるかに超えて私たちの本当の子を示すのは私たちの選択です。
And there you have it. Hope you like this video and find it useful for your next creative project. Do share this with someone who would find this useful and subscribe to follow for more tutorials like this as we explore how AI could elevate our creativity. Till then, see you in the next video. Peace.